Very good morning to all the students of class 10th D. We are doing chapter Diary of Anne Frank, and introduction is well given to you, and it's been 3 days now we have been doing this. And you can see the characters on the board, you can see some value points on the board also that I would be discussing now. Now most of the students have joined. So let's firstly understand, better there are many more characters in this actually, but this is not the novel, the complete novel, which is written by Anne Frank. This is one extract only. Fine. This is just one part of that novel, Diary of Young Girl. And they changed the name to Diary of Anne Frank and made it a chapter for your class. Fine. So they have mainly discussed the classroom scene in this, that how firstly they have mentioned that how she got this diary on 13th birthday. She decided to write on it, and then how she made first entry about her life, about her parents, about sister, and then she mentioned about her grandmother also. Find that how she was connected to her, how she was very loving, you can say, grandmother, and she loved her grandmother so much. Even after her death, she was just lighting a candle on for you can say on birthday. So after reading this now, and how she addresses her diary. Anybody can tell me what is the name of the diary she has kept for? Raise your hand for this. Tanya is the very first one. Okay, Tanya, you speak then.
She addresses her as Kitty.
Yes, she addressed her diary as Kitty. Yes, many students have. Yes, Bisham, we are done now. So, dearest Kitty, now we'll be reading from page number 52, but before that, let me tell you the points which we are going to cover. Are you able to see all the points, or shall I adjust the camera? No, I guess. Sometimes. Yes, nothing worth having comes easy is the quote of the day. Fine. It means if you want to achieve something, the cost of it you have to pay. You have to work hard for it. And the things which are worth having, you need to put in double, triple efforts for that. You won't be getting your, you can say, it easily. Clear? So nothing worth having comes easy. You need to put in effort. So the way Anne Frank wrote diary for 2 years, fine. So success is not the, you can say, efforts made in just one day. Sometimes it takes days and weeks and years also. So characters they have mentioned in this chapter mainly, Anne Frank, who's the protagonist, Otto Frank, father of Anne Frank. She was 13 years old when she got this diary on her birthday. Fine. Edith Frank, mother of Anne Frank. Then Margot Frank, she's the elder sister. She's 16 years old. You can say 3 years elder than her sister. You can say from Anne Frank, she's 3 years older. Then Mr. Keesing is the new character I have introduced here. Fine. Mr. Keesing is the, he's going to play a very important part in this, because she would be interacting with the teacher a lot. He's a maths teacher. And rather than, you know, it's a teacher's work to always create awareness amongst the students that one should attend, be attentive in the class. Whenever you would, you know, talk in the class, teachers would say, okay, call names, stand up, and the teacher would ask you questions sometimes. Every teacher has a different way of making the student realize, find that whether you are doing something right or wrong. So Mr. Keesing, when he finds that Anne Frank talks a lot in the class, he would be, you know, giving an assignment to her. So this is his way of mending ways of his students. Rather than scolding and saying anything else or asking her to leave the class, he would give assignment to this girl, and which is apt as per. Some students are facing network issues. Kindly check your networks with them. So value points which we are going to cover, and maybe we'll be able to finish the chapter also. Mr. Keesing assigned Anne an essay, a chatterbox. Who's a chatterbox? Anybody can tell me what is the meaning of a chatterbox here in this context? Any other child? Tanya is the one who raised hand, already given answer. Person who talks a lot, yes. So Bisham has already given the answer in the chat box. A person who speaks a lot, Princy says. Yes, Dakshita says, the person who speaks continuously. Fine. So chatterbox is the person who loves to talk, who talks a lot. Fine. And sometimes there is no need also, even then the person keeps on talking. Clear? Then we call that person a chatterbox. So Mr. Keesing assigned Anne an essay. When she would be discussing everything in her diary only. Right now she is not going to school, she is in the hiding only. So she is mentioning her experiences that how Mr. Keesing would call her a chatterbox when he finds her talking. And Anne wrote 3 pages on it. Rather than be ashamed of it, she went back home and she thought and she gave beautiful arguments that why she's called a chatterbox. Because her mother talks a lot. This is genetic. This is inherited from the mother only. So that's why she's a chatterbox. So she would be writing 3 pages on this essay. And when teacher reads it, rather than scolding, he's a very nice and genuine teacher. He, you know, laughs it out. He just takes it very casually, fine. And then Mr. Keesing gave her another essay. Next day also she keeps on talking. That essay writing does not bring change in her. She keeps on talking and Mr. Keesing gave her another topic, an incorrigible chatterbox, fine, which cannot be handled even. So then again, she did not stop or mend her ways. And finally, he gave quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. So it was maybe out of teacher was also getting frustrated that why this girl doesn't stop talking. Clear? So he gave finally this topic. So we would be reading, what does she do? What was her reaction? Fine. So all the value points, all the characters are clear to everyone. If any doubt, you can ask me. I would be sharing the screen now, Beta. Everything is clear? Send me thumbs up. If you keep doubts with you, beta, you won't be able to understand anything. Okay, now screens are visible to you. So we are on page number 52. I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We will make it. Now, why? What is she talking about here? She's talking about that next day they were about to get their results. Fine. So teacher was about to announce results that who would be going to next class. But everybody was feeling, you can say, quite tensed. Everybody was, you can say, shaking with fear and excitement and nervousness, all the mixed feelings. And Anne Frank is discussing about her feelings. She's saying, I'm not so worried about my girlfriends and myself. We will make it. So she's sure that definitely she will go to next grade. The only subject I'm not sure about is maths. Fine. The only subject which she is not sure about is maths. Anyway, all we can do is wait. Until then, we keep telling each other not to lose heart. I get along pretty well with all my teachers. There are 9 of them. Underline this, 7 men and 2 women. Mr. Keesing, the old Foje who teaches maths, was annoyed with me for ages because I talked so much. An old-fashioned person. You know, sometimes we have preconceptions about teachers also. Find some, you think that, okay, this teacher doesn't like me. He keeps on or she keeps on calling my name all the time, asking me only to answer or pointing me out. But sometimes, you know, it's nothing like that. Just we have preconceived notions. So this is the thought of Anne Frank about Mr. Keesing, that he's annoyed with me because I talked so much. So this is the reality. She is a chatterbox. She talks a lot. After several warnings, he assigned me extra homework. So you just read it carefully. On one hand, she's saying that he's annoyed with me for ages. And on the other hand, she's saying after several warnings, it means Mr. Keesing had been giving warnings to her to stop talking. But even then she did not stop. So who's at fault here? Anne Frank is at fault that she did not stop talking. So when he gave lots of warnings and even then she did not stop, he found another way. He assigned me extra homework, an essay on the subject, a chatterbox. A chatterbox, what can you write about that? I would worry about that later, I decided. I jotted down the title in my notebook, tucked it in my bag, and tried to keep quiet. Again, she's saying, I tried to keep quiet. It means she was not able to sit quietly. She was a very talkative girl. That evening, after I had finished, now, beta, one rule, let me tell you, whenever you find this contraction here, apostrophe D, many students, they start saying, I would, or others say, I did, or means, I, sorry, had, right? How would you know that, what you have to pronounce? If you have to see the verb following this contraction. If it is in third form, like here they have written finished, fine. This is one grammatical rule I'm telling you. Then you will say, I had finished, fine. And if verb first form is mentioned here, V1 is written, suppose it is written finish, then you will say, I would finish, okay? If first form is there, you will speak this D as would. If past participle or third form is written here, then you would be pronouncing this D as had. Okay, is it clear, this rule? So that evening, after I had finished the rest of my homework, the note about the essay caught my eye. I began thinking about the subject while chewing the tip of my fountain pen. Anyone could ramble on and leave big spaces between the words, but the trick was to come up with convincing arguments to prove the necessity of talking. So she thought, teacher has given me this work, I would definitely write about it then. But what can be written on this topic, Chandrabox? I thought, and suddenly I had an idea. I wrote the 3 pages Mr. Keesing had assigned me and was satisfied. I argued that talking is a student's trait. So that was the first argument. This is the quality, a trait of a student, that he would definitely talk, that I would do my best to keep it under control. And secondly, she also mentioned that she would try to control this rate of talking, but that I would never be able to cure myself of the habit. The next argument was given, that she is not able to, you know, completely leave this habit because my mother talked as much as I did. That because my mother is also talkative, the way I talk, she also talks. And there is not much you can do about inherited traits. So she is giving very convincing argument here that this is inherited from my mother because she talks a lot. That's why I am also talkative. So Mr. Keesing had a good laugh at my arguments, but when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson. So after reading the essay, Mr. Keesing just was laughing and he just laughed it out. He did not say anything to this girl. Then next lesson started and again she started talking. Then Mr. Keesing assigned me a second essay. This time it was supposed to be an incorrigible that cannot be corrected. Means the person or quality which is there permanently with you. An incorrigible chatterbox. I handed it in and Mr. Keesing had nothing to complain about for 2 whole sessions. However, during the third lesson, he would finally had enough and Frank, as punishment for talking in class, write an essay entitled Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. So he was thinking, this is enough now. This girl does not stop talking. So he kept on giving essays to her. Others are laughing. You can say the other children in the class, because every time your friends, you know, you remember when you were in class, whenever your friends, even during online classes, if teacher is taking anyone's name, some students cannot stop themselves while sending emojis, though we keep on saying we are not supposed to. But even then, you people laugh. So others always laugh if one is getting scolded. This is also the student's trait, I must say. The class roared. I had to laugh too. So everybody was actually, they burst into laughter. Roar doesn't mean they started roaring. They started laughing and she also started laughing, though I would nearly exhausted my ingenuity on the topic of chatterboxes. It was time to come up with something else. Now she's thinking, already I have written 3 pages. What else I can write about such kind of incorrigible chatterboxes? It was time to come up with something else, something original. My friend Sane, who is good at poetry, offered to help me to write the essay from beginning to end in verse. And I jumped for joy. See, They're so excited about writing an essay. She's not listening to the teacher that I should keep quiet in the class, rather than she's wasting her energy. This is a trait actually, that she's able to write well. Fine. She made a poem out of it with the help of one of her friends named San. And she started writing an incorrigible chatterbox in a verse form, in a form of poetry. Mr. Keezing was trying to play a joke on me with this ridiculous subject, but I would make sure the joke was on him. So this is a kind of cold war which is going on between teacher and student. Teacher is giving homework so that she would stop talking, but rather than keeping mum or rather than stopping this habit, she is giving, you know, answer back to the teacher in the way of writing only. So she wrote a poetry second time. I would be asking you, beta. First time she wrote 3 pages on a chatterbox. Secondly, she wrote a verse, V-E-R-S-E, which means poetical form of essay on topic, an incorrigible chatterbox. Fine. Teacher was also not stopping. The students were also not stopping. So I finished my poem and it was beautiful. It was about a mother duck and a father swan with 3 baby ducklings who were bitten to death by father because they quacked too much. See, she wrote a poem and the subject of the poem was, she just, you know, actually personified characters in this. She was trying to put forth the point in front of the teacher that it is the inherited trait of everyone. Everyone will speak. Don't stop them. She's trying to convey that to her teacher only. So she, the subject she chose was a mother duck and a swan father and 3 ducklings. And they were beaten to death by the father because they quacked too much. And it is the, you know, what will a duck, what is the voice or sound produced by a duck or ducklings? It's quack, quack, quack only. So what else a duckling would do? Nothing. So she's actually cracking a joke out of it that 3 ducklings were beaten to death by father because they quacked too much. So it's sarcastic remark on the teacher only. Fine. Mr. Keezing took the joke right away. Even then, this is the, you can say, decency of the teacher, Mr. Keezing. He would have informed the principal also about it. He would have given punishment to this girl also. But even then, he took this joke healthily. You know, some people, they do not take jokes healthily. Some people, they start, you know, feeling bad about it, or teacher has, you know, found me only in the whole class, or some students will say, yes, I was talking, so that's why teacher, you know, pointed out me. So that is the way of taking the things lightly, or how you want to take the things. Teacher was also not taking the things very seriously, and student Anne Frank was also not taking it seriously. He read the poem to the class. So you can see, rather than scolding the girl, he read this poem loudly, adding his own comments and to several other classes as well. So not only in this class, he read this poem that, see, I gave one assignment to my student and she wrote this beautiful poem. So Mr. Keezing was taking it very healthily. Since then, I have been allowed to talk and have not been assigned any extra homework. On the contrary, Mr. Keezing's always making jokes these days. So she's saying, she's telling this thing to her diary kitty, okay, that I talked a lot and my teacher gave me this chatterbox. Then again, I talked, he gave me incorrigible chatterbox. I wrote a poem about it. Again, he gave me a topic, quack, quack, said Mistress Chatterbox. I wrote a story about ducklings and swan and duck about it. And after that, Mr. Keezing was satisfied and he started discussing and narrating this story to the class and other classes as well. And since then, he has not assigned me. So it means you would be telling me that why Mr. Keezing, you know, he does not say anything to this girl. Why? Mr. Keezing is always making jokes these days. And he himself started cracking jokes in the classes. Yours, Anne. Yours, Anne. Why? Because it's a diary entry. At last, she has signed. See, you can see the bracketed information extracted from the diary of a young girl with slight adaptation. Slight change they have done because they could not exactly put all the words here. So that's why. So we would be doing question answers, no doubt. Now it's time for you people to tell me why Mr. Kesey did not say anything to Anne Frank. Any one of you? Raise your hand, beta. Come on. Why Mr. Frank? Sorry, Mr. Kesey. Nobody's there? Shall I call the name then? Yes, Tanya. Tanya, you can...
Ma'am, Mr. Kesey by nature was a nice and genuine person. As he didn't want to scold her or treat her badly, so he gave her essays to make her feel bad. As he gave her essay of a chatterbox and an incorrigible chatterbox, and then she wrote a poem on that.
So what we can take out of this incident is, you can mute yourself better. Actually, Mr. Kesey wanted to mend her ways, right? He wanted to, you know, make her realize that talking should not be there in the class when teacher is teaching. But when he tried first way by giving an essay, she wrote beautifully. Another way, she wrote a poem. Another way, she wrote a story out of it. And then he found that this girl is not going to change herself. This is me. I have to change myself only. So I have to accept this girl the way she is. And, you know, every child is not same. In class, if you are having 50 students, and they are all different, coming from different backgrounds, having different natures. Some are very, you know, innocent. Some are very sharp. Some are very, sensitive. Those who will not take the things on a joke basis. But some are very, you can say, jolly natured kids also. So it's up to the teacher how he or she handles the class. Fine. And teacher Kesey was happily accepting the girl the way she is. That's why they have mentioned at the end that rather than, you know, stopping me, he himself started creating jokes these days. So he accepted the students the way they were rather than changing them. One should change, yes, no doubt. It doesn't mean that she's kept on talking. You people will also say, okay, we should also talk. No. Yeah, this is one or the other way. So we are left with 5 minutes. Now let's continue with the questions. Why was Mr. Kesey annoyed with Anne? And what did he ask her to do? Very easy question. I won't give any answer now. Princy, beta, you can give answer to this question. Why was Mr. Kesey annoyed with Anne? And what did he ask her to do?
Mr. Kesey was annoyed by the Anne's habit of speaking a lot. He asked him to write an essay on chatterbox.
Fine, a chatterbox. Very good. Clear? Harsimran is writing an answer with Anne because she talks a lot. So Harsimran, if you would like to give answer to another question, beta, you can speak. How did Anne justify her being a chatterbox in her essay? Harsimran, are you there? Saksham Grover has raised hand. Yes, Harsimran? Okay, so I switch this question to Saksham Grover. You're not able to connect to Harsimran. Yes.
And he justified her behavior of being talkative because she said that being chatty is a trait of every student, and she said that her mother is also talkative, so she had inherited this trait from her parents.
So first argument was given by her that it's and you can say it's a trait of every student that he or she should talk, and secondly, nothing can be done about the inherited traits. Her mother talks a lot, that's why she also talks. Fine. Do you think Mr. Kesey was a strict teacher? Now, here views can be splitted, I guess. What do you think? Raise hand. Do you think Mr. Keesing was a strict teacher? Only these four questions, I guess, we'll be able to do. Rest we'll do tomorrow. Any other student? I want maximum participation. Dakshita, yes, Beta, you can speak.
Yes, I think Mr. Keesing was a strict teacher because he punishes. He wanted the students to concentrate on the studies. He often punishes Anne Frank by giving her essays. When Anne argued with her teacher, he also gave her a second essay to write. This shows that Mr. Keesing was a strict in nature.
Fine. So, as I told you, this question can be answered in both ways. Some students can say, yes, Mr. Keesing was a strict teacher. That's why he never allowed students to talk in the class. And he was very particular in, rather than, you know, concentrating on teaching, he's more interested in mending the ways of the student. That way we can say he's a strict teacher. But what I personally feel is Mr. Keesing was not that strict teacher. Had he been strict teacher, he would have given punishment to Anne Frank. But rather than giving punishment, he did not say anything to her. He kept on giving essay writing to her only, being a maths teacher. Fine. So you can say that Mr. Keesing was not that strict teacher because rather than giving, you can say, punishment to Anne Frank, he was trying to mend her ways politely by giving her assignments so that she realizes herself her mistake. Fine. So she wanted that. He wanted that students must self, do self analysis to understand their mistake rather than he gave punishment to them. So we can say that Mr. Keesing was not a strict teacher, but yes, he was a true disciplinarian. Clear? A true disciplinarian doesn't mean that the person who's a follower of discipline will be strict also. Yes, both things can be there, but he was a very understanding teacher. Clear? Now, last question for today. What made Mr. Keesing allow Anne to talk in the class? At last, you have read that he accepted Anne Frank the way she was. And rather than scolding her, he himself started cracking jokes. What do you think about it? Why he allowed Anne to talk in the class? Whatever your views are, kindly share. So we are left with only 1 or 2 minutes. So let me answer this. Okay, Bissam has written because Anne won the debate. He knew that she's not going to change. Yes. Okay, Bissam, kindly write. Okay, this time you're writing in the chat box. So, but when you write in the notebooks, then use formal language only. Okay, gona, vana, they are not the words. They are just slangs in the English language. Okay, beta. So, yes, irrelenting nature of Anne. Saksham is writing. Fine. So, when Mr. Keesing tried to mend her ways by giving her 3 assignments, and even after 3 assignments, she did not change her ways. So teacher thought it's better to accept Anne Frank the way she is. So he himself made changes in his behavior so that students start feeling comfortable with the teacher. So that's a good trait of teacher also. He accepted the students as they were because he knew that this girl is incorrigible. Her ways cannot be mended. Fine. So he accepted the students as. Okay, beta. So tomorrow we will be doing thinking about the text and other exercises at the back. Fine. Tomorrow we will be finishing this chapter off. Clear? Or if we'll get a chance, we'll be doing some writing skill also. Okay, beta. Have a nice day. And only 3-4 students are left. Those who have not sent their homework, I have put in the group. Kindly read your names and send immediately today. Today is the last day. Okay. Dishant, finally. Have a nice day, everyone.